060, pues hablar ahora con un poco sobre la serie V8 Super V8 Cars de Australia, que como les decía en la presentación del programa, están esta semana acá en Estados Unidos, y vamos a hablar con el campeón de esta serie del año 2010, James Courtney, un piloto que ha tenido mucho éxito en esa serie, y después los últimos dos años, como nos va a decir en la entrevista, realmente no le ha ido tan bien, la competencia es muy dura. Nos habla un poco de lo que es esa serie, también de lo que él puede ver desde Australia sobre la NASCAR, digamos, que es lo que más se compara acá en Estados Unidos con esa serie de Supercars V8 de allá. Y bueno, los ajustes que tienen que hacer a veces los pilotos. Él también fue piloto de pruebas de la Fórmula 1, y el ajuste quizá a una nueva serie a veces es complicado. Así que bueno, vamos a escuchar la entrevista que hicimos esta semana a través del teléfono con James Courtney, que está en el circuito de las Américas allá en Austin para una fecha puntuable de la serie de Super Cars V8 de Australia.
Hello James, thank you very much for taking the time. You are in Austin getting ready for the first ever V8 Supercar Austin 400 here in the States. How are you?
I'm great. I can't wait to get out there and start driving and show you the Americans what the championship's all about.
Well, start telling me, because I don't know much about, to be honest. I've seen a few videos. Actually, I remember probably a year or two ago, there was a horrific accident in, I think it was one of your races, in a car that stalled at the start, and then the car behind just crashed in the back and had, like, horrible accident. And I think, if I'm correct, that's the only thing I ever seen about this series.
Yeah, it's very, very new, obviously, to the U.S. market, so it's a great championship. It's quite a bit of contact in our championship, and produces great racing, but it's quite spectacular, so there's always something exciting happening.
So what are the specification of the cars? All the cars have to be the same exactly as it is in other series, or how are the cars?
Yeah, no, very much like that. Like with NASCAR, everyone has the same chassis. Different manufacturers have different aero packages and bodies, and their own engine supplied, but the chassis is the same for everyone, and we are allowed to make more modifications than what you can with NASCAR, but it's a good championship, and the racing's very, very close and always very exciting.
Yeah, and let me ask you something. How challenging is to race, to come all the way here and race here, because, I mean, Australia is a far away from here.
Yeah, it's obviously a lot more work getting everything here. So it's planning's a lot more, but it's gonna be an interesting weekend. No one's had any driving on this track before, so no one can go and use like last year's setup or anything like that. So it's gonna be a lot of work and trying a lot of things in practice to get everything right. But I think it's gonna be good. Good fun.
Yeah, so have you already driven in the Circuit of the Americas?
No, I just did some demonstration last week, but
I mean, not driven for the competition, but like around the track?
Yeah, just driven around to have a look and
what do you think?
Yeah, it looks good. I think they've done a good job. The facility is fantastic. The track looks great, the layout, but it's gonna be so much better when we have everyone else on there.
Yeah, of course.
Fun.
And this the V8 supercar series in Australia is mostly like this kind of tracks, or it's ovals like here with NASCAR?
No, it's all how do you say? It's all road courses. So it produces good racing and mixes it up a little. Our championship doesn't race on any ovals, but could be something to have fun to go off one time.
So, James, you were the champion of the series in 2010, if I'm correct?
Yeah, I won the championship 2010.
Now, what happened the past 2 years?
didn't win. It wasn't good enough. I changed teams, and it's been a little bit different, and we haven't had the success that we had previously. So, we're working hard as a team to improve that. The car's a lot better this year, and hopefully we can get after it and get the championship.
So this race in Austin is a part of the regular season?
Yes, it's for full championship points. So
And how far are we into the season, and how are you doing this year?
Yeah, we're four rounds in. It's still very, very tight with the points. I think I'm eighth at the moment, so it's sort of as far to the front what I need to be. But look, it's a lot of racing. We've got, I think, 10 rounds left, so it's a long way to go before the championship's decided.
Yeah. And is it this series as competitive as NASCAR is? NASCAR has like 45 drivers on every race, and you see the time differences are like, especially for qualifying, is like tens of hundreds of a second. Is that is the series pretty much the same as close as it is with NASCAR here?
Yeah, exactly the same. That championship is incredibly tight. So I'd say it's very, very similar like that. We have, there's, I think from the four rounds we've had this year, there's been eight different winners from those events.
Wow.
It's very, very close.
Yeah. And let me ask you something. We're talking about NASCAR. What do you think about the series? Do you watch it? Do you follow it back there in Australia?
Yeah, I watch a little bit. I don't watch that much of it. But, if I've got nothing to do when it's on, I have a look.
Hello?
Hello?
Oh, yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, no, I watch it, but the racing's very, very different, but for sure, I have a look.
Yeah, and so you've been driving this era since when?
My first season was 2007.
Yeah, and then you also driven in Europe, right? Like you were in some Formula One teams, like a test drivers and things like that?
Yeah, I did 3 years with Jaguar Formula One team, which is now Red Bull.
Yeah.
I've got a lot of experience. I raced in Europe for 14 years, so it's...
And having had experience with Formula One, at least at that level, and coming up to this kind of driving, racing, for example, like we have the case of Juan Pablo Montoya, who I'm sure you know who he is. He was pretty successful, more or less. He wasn't a champion in Formula One, and then he came to NASCAR, and he hasn't done much. What do you think is that different?
I think with everything, I think a lot of it is down to team. The cars are very, very different to what he used to, but I think it's just very different, very unique, the championship.
Yeah, I'm more competitive, I guess. I'm more close competition. So James Courtney, one of the drivers from the BA Supercars Australian Series. When is the race in Austin?
This weekend. We race Saturday and Sunday, so you should get out and have a look.
Yeah. And is there a webpage or somewhere where people can follow you and learn more about you and your career?
Yeah, you can follow me on Twitter, which I'm at jcourtney01, or I have a webpage, which is jamescourtney.com.au.
Well, thank you very much for your time, James, and good luck this weekend here in the U.S. and the rest of the season back there in Australia.
All right. Cheers. Thank you.
Thank you. Good night.
Bueno, esa es la entrevista con James Courtney, el piloto de la serie VA de Australia. Interesante escuchar cómo, por ejemplo, nos hablaba de lo que él entiende que puede haber sido la dificultad que tuvo un piloto muy controvertido, del que siempre se habla mucho al hablar de Fórmula 1 y NASCAR, que es Juan Pablo Montoya, que tuvo mucho éxito en la Fórmula 1, ganando algunos premios, y bueno, ahora en la NASCAR está, este año parece que está haciendo lo mejor, así que ojalá que eso sea cierto. Pues muchas gracias, sobre todo ahí a Santi Rodríguez, que nos está ayudando en los controles esta semana. Estamos poniendo toda la información de este show en, como les decía, en facebook.com/auto060. Y recuerden que la frecuencia de Cristina Radio Network se ha mudado al canal 153 de SiriusXM Radio. Nos vemos la próxima semana en Auto 060. Yo soy Javier Mo.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.